In the early hours of New Year's Day, 1947, steam locomotive number 3512 slides off a barge into one of Canada's deepest lakes. At 97 years old, the last living crew member aids an expedition to find this lost train. His accounts hold crucial information for the investigative team tasked to rediscover this piece of North American rail history.
And I remember the skipper hollering to one of the deckhands to cut that cable.
When 3512 went down, we were just coming out of the Second World War.
Oh, there's a massive smash, all right. Remember, lots of bubbles and the waves.
It may have caused a boiler explosion.
Yeah, I would say we were quite lucky.
Slocan Lake lies in quiet southeastern BC's Kootenay region, surrounded by the towering Selkirk and Valhalla mountain ranges.
Where we live is in the middle of nowhere in BC. The lake is nice and clean, and there's no pollution, natural fed from the mountains. I've spent my time out with search and rescue, fire rescue. 10-foot waves going to fish people out of the water. You gotta respect this lake, definitely.
The fact that it is extremely deep, this is serious stuff. We're looking in depths of 720 feet, right? So that's part of the history, is to know we have a locomotive in the Slocan Lake. We should look at it.
I am flesh and I am bone, rise up, ting ting like glitter and gold.
The Cranes did everything. They brought in the supplies, they took out the ore, brought the people in, especially the miners. If it wasn't for the Cranes, this would never have happened.
It was the primary engine of the Canadian economy. BC is very much on their own. If they hadn't had the railway connection, I think they definitely would have become part of the United States.
The barge was down at the back and then and tipping towards one side. And when they cut the cable, it just kept going, dumped everything off the side.
In the middle of the winter, freezing cold, in the dark, there must have been no choice. Had to cut it loose, otherwise they all would have went into the water.
So knowing what we've got now, knowing the topography, there is enough data that puts us into the right location.
We'll be using our high-definition cameras on the sub as well as the sonar system.
So we get this thing tied up or tangled, we've lost it. That's the biggest concern. You know, it's a big train, right? How easy it is to find it. Just with the conditions, you never know.
The term hogger came from the fact that a steam locomotive was known as a hog, simply because it was big and fat.
Some said it, you know, it was 5 miles north of Slocan. Some said it was near the Cape Horn Bluffs.
We're old school, but we love what we're doing.
As far as finding that engine, I think it's hopeless. That's what I'd say, it's absolutely hopeless.
Hey, oh, go back there. 3512.
There you go.
There you go.
Oh yes. My God.